Hey everyone, my name is Denzo from Nashor. Today we'll be talking about the A6600 and how you can set up this camera for time-lapse shooting. So in this video, we'll be looking at how to set up your interval shooting function on the Sony A6600, how to set up a custom button for interval shooting. Just show you a sample of a time-lapse video we took of a sunset here in Port Moresby. Alright, let's make a start. So first of all, to switch on, just turn the switch on here at the top near the shutter button. So that's to power up your camera. Now that we have the camera on, we just click on this menu button here. In the first menu page, we scroll right to 3 out of 4 tabs and we scroll down to interval shooting. So to scroll right or to scroll up or down, you just use this wheel here to the right of the display. Just click on the button here in the middle. Currently we have the interval shooting at off. If you're trying to select the interval shooting and it refuses, you just and then jump back into the menu and then you can should be able to turn on your interval shooting. A shooting start time, just to avoid the shake on the first shot after you press the shutter button, you should keep yourself a few seconds. So I've set mine at 10. Usually after I clicked on the shutter button, I'm just checking that there's no other wobble in relation to the tripod itself. Just look to the sides of the camera to make sure that there's no one approaching that will come into view first and second shot. If you prefer to reduce the shooting start time, do so by pressing downwards. Otherwise, if you want to increase, you just press up on the wheel. Coming down to shooting interval, usually when I set up to take time lapses or landscape scenery, I select 5 seconds to take either sunset or slow moving clouds. If you are closer to the action or closer to crowds or traffic, reduce this down to 3 or 2 seconds. Now the number of shots, I've got it at 400. Again, you can always scroll across and then reduce this down to whatever number of shots you prefer. I just keep it on 400. Sometimes I don't use 400, but you can always stop the shooting midway by just pressing the shutter button and that will end your interval shooting. So with 400 shots at shooting interval of 5 seconds, you can see the shooting time required will be 33 minutes. The next step, which I recommend, is to go up to the second menu page, scroll across until you come to tab 8 out of 9 and select the custom key here. 2 out of 4 on this custom key menu, interested in the interval shooting. I think the default, the first got this camera, was on self-timer during bracket. I've just changed that to interval shooting. You've set up your interval shooting function. You've set up your custom key for interval shooting. I think the only thing left now is to set up your manual settings for interval shooting. So switching to manual here at the top. Depending on the location, you've probably got your shot plan ready, whether it's for a sunset, slow moving clouds, crowd build-ups, events. Based on your shot plan and activity you're trying to take, this is where you, apart from setting up on the tripod, this is where you set up your manual setting. If you want to change your shutter speed, you just press on the display button, which is on the top of the wheel. Double click, and this brings up a shutter speed here, shown in the middle. Turning the wheel right speeds up the shutter, and turning it left slows it down. If you want to make any changes to your aperture, it's this dial on the top here, the far right. You can turn anti-clockwise or clockwise. ISO on the right of the wheel, just click on that. You just scroll up and down to reduce or increase your ISO. Next up, we'll just show you a quick example of time-lapse video we took of a sunset here in Port Moresby.